Hey, hey, party people, it's Lycona DiCicci, and rating season is almost upon us once again. And rather than just have a list of things you should do to prepare, I'd like to share with you how to prep yourself mentally for a raid. How do we get you in the right mindset when we first step into a fight, to working with your team, to how to perform at your best? So let's get right into it. So first things first, it's about your job. Obviously, you want to practice your opener and rotation. This one's pretty straightforward. You want to sit down and take a few play sessions in order to master your opener and your job. And the more comfortable you are with your job, the more comfortable you'll be when you're progressing through a fight in raid. If you practice enough to get to a point to where your openers and your rotations, depending on what job you choose, becomes muscle memory, then it gives you more brain power to focus on the fight and the mechanics, like whatever fight it may be, whether it's a trial or whether it's a raid. So it's just one less thing to worry about, and it's one thing that you can do to practice on your time, rather than having to both learn the fight and learn your job at the same time. If you can learn your job separately and then learn the fight, it makes raid progression that much easier. Next is always have food in pots. Food at least the minimum. It'll boost your DPS and HP, and while it might not seem like much, over the entirety of a fight, it can mean the difference between a clear and a 1% wipe. Generally, I like to use pots when we're either up against a DPS check or we're about to clear a fight. Since pots are relatively expensive, I like to use fireworks instead of pots during raid progression. The reason is because you can save some gil, and the cooldown timer for both fireworks and pots are the same. So it's just a little tip to save some gil when you're practicing your opener and rotations by incorporating pots into them. Next is to focus on just one main job and be the absolute best at it. If you're like me and work 50 hours a week in real life, you really can't take up too much time to learn all the different abilities and all the different jobs. While you can learn multiple jobs eventually, during raid season, it's best to just stick with one or two. It allows you to focus all of your attention to optimizing that job, learning its skills, and its openers and rotations. It'll even help you with your playstyle and positioning during fights. Say if there's a stack or a spread AoE and you're playing melee, then you'll probably dodge towards the boss, whereas if you're ranged DPS, you'll be dodging away. Whether you're playing a tank, healer, or DPS, if you get to the point where you're not having to think about your job and your role, then the easier it is to focus on the fight and the mechanics. So, in other words, know your job inside and out, all of its abilities, all of its skills, and bring yourself to the raid ready to go. So, let's talk about raid progression. I like to split up a fight into three phases: the learning phase, the discussion phase, and the clearing phase. The learning phase is exactly what it means. You're there to learn, and your party's going to wipe a lot. And that's okay, we're learning, right? Sometimes you may want to catch a video or read up on a guide before you dive in. Other times you can just go in and face roll through the fight and learn the mechanics on the fly. The thing is, everyone learns differently, but there are two things that I've found that are always consistent about any raid or any trial that I have ever done. First, always be open to changes in strategy if they're not working. And second, if your strategies are successful in clearing certain stages of a fight, don't change them. Now, there's always going to be mini optimizations, pug strats, different guides posted online. The thing to remember here is to be flexible and be open to changes depending on your group. I know that when I raid, I don't have all the answers and I might not see all the mechanics, but being open to adjusting my playstyle, where I move, how I position, where I DPS, who do I hit, when you're open to taking all of that advice and learning on the go and learning from your other party members, you're going to be a better player. And not only that, your team's going to benefit as well because you're playing your job to the best of its ability. And when everyone plays their job to the best of their abilities, that's when you guys go get the clear. But before we get to the clear, it leads us into the discussion phase, which is where your team develops the strategies to clear fight mechanics. Some mechanics are intuitive and simple, while others take some coordination and a lot of practice. Try to keep discussions focused on the next mechanic your party is having trouble with, rather than discussing mechanics that are way later in the fight. Of course, it's always a good thing to know what's coming next, but talking about last phase mechanics when you haven't even cleared the first phase mechanics is usually unproductive. The discussion phase is also the most dangerous phase, because it's where most groups fall apart. But it's not from the fight itself, it's with your team. And it usually starts when folks start blaming each other for mistakes or blaming somebody because they may have caused a wipe. Stop it. Cut it out. It's unproductive. It doesn't help anybody. It doesn't help the party. Or worse yet, if somebody starts blaming other people, usually everyone's emotions get flustered, which in turn, you're less likely to clear a fight if everyone's emotionally upset. Try to remain emotionally neutral. Take a step back, relax, see what happened, see what went wrong, address the issue, and get right back into it. And the more you get back into it, the more that you're going to progress through the fight. The more that you take out emotions and think logically about how to beat the next mechanic, how to clear the next mechanic, the faster your progression will be and the sooner you will get a clear. Which brings us to the last phase, which is the clearing phase. It's the point where you've seen all the mechanics of a fight, and now you're going for the clear. The thing you gotta remember here is that DPS naturally increases the more your team gets comfortable with a fight and its mechanics. Eventually, you'll reach a point where you've executed all the mechanics properly, but just don't quite have enough DPS to get the clear. So use pots, use foods, even try to optimize your movements, readjust your strats to have more DPS uptime. Just keep in mind how to best optimize your job, optimize the fight, and work with your party to get the best results. At this point as well, it should be all business. Try removing as much emotion out of the equation as possible, and just focus on clearing the fight. Keep the comm channels open for raid callouts, and keep casual conversations to a minimum. Another thing too is that when you're so close to a clear, my heart starts racing at like 1,000 miles an hour. And I know what I'm asking is nearly impossible, but remain focused and remain calm all throughout the fight, even down to the last 1%. Don't worry, you'll get the chance to scream and cheer once the screen fades to black and you see that boss go down. So that's it, really. I really like to focus on those things when I'm raiding. And there's one more thing. 95% of a successful raid is just showing up on time. Because the more time you spend in the fight, the more you're going to learn it, the more you're going to progress through it, and the sooner you and your team are going to get that clear. So that's it, and I hope this guide helped you guys out a little bit. Let me know in the comments below if you think I missed something, or if you have anything to add if you're a serious raider. Let me know. And until next time, keep on adventuring!